Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Good evening to all brethren. Today we have decided to know about land rights and how to make a petition with the Honorable Court to save our land and its affairs and its difficulties. First of all, I want to explain to you, my dear brethren, first we should be very careful in making a petition to the Honorable Court. Why? Because we should not give an impression to mislead the Honorable Court. And most important point is, we are not saying that somebody has occupied our land. No. It's will be an innocent statement. But if we cleverly approach the Honorable Courts and say, Honorable Sir, so and so is trying his best to interfere my rights in this land of survey number 27, Vijayawada 2, then we should be saying that he is interfering with my rights of this land. So I request your Honorable Sir that he should be prevented, or an important action should be taken so that he might not interfere with the rights of my land in survey number 27, and kindly instruct him to be away with his affairs and kindly protect my rights of this land in Vijayawada. I request for that, Your Honor.
Sir, kindly explain the procedure involved in approaching courts with reference to our legal problems of land.
First of all, we should be very, very careful in making a petition to the Honorable Courts. Now, I will give you some examples. Supposing somebody has occupied our land, but we will not be stating that somebody has occupied our land. No, we will be very careful in selecting words. Then we will be writing, so Honorable Sir, so and so has occupied a certain lands in survey number 27 of Vijayawada 2. And he is interfering with the rights of this land. So I want to approach your Honorable Sir, explaining that you kindly take necessary action to prevent him in interfering with my rights of this land. Here, very important point to be noted is, we are not giving a statement that so and so has occupied my land. No, we are not informing this matter, but we are telling so and so is trying to interfere with the rights of my land. So, I want to approach the Honorable Court to mend this situation and inform him that he is not taking a right action, but he is trying to make some situation and take away my rights by interfering with the rights of this land.
Sir, kindly explain me, what are the steps I have to take when anybody interferes in my affairs of land?
The foremost and important step is, there are broadly spoken, there are two kinds of cases, one civil cases another is criminal cases. Civil cases deal with civil matters, for example, like land matters, land affairs, so and so. Criminal matters means if you violate anybody's rights and if you violate peace, then police come to the picture. Then police laws and police petitions will be the important thing for us to decide. But as far as land affairs are decided, there are so many kinds of civil affairs and civil courts. For example, junior courts, junior civil courts, district courts, high courts, and then Supreme Court. So, according to the matter, we have to select to which court we have to approach, according to jurisdiction, whether it is good, whether it is small court or big court. This is the first thing we have to decide. After that, you see, we are not saying our problem directly, but we are approaching to the Honorable that only my land affairs and interference with the rights of my land are being violated by so and so man. We are not saying somebody has occupied my land, somebody has troubling me. No, my rights are being violated by so and so. Kindly take necessary action to prevent this thing. This much of approach is enough for us. We need not go into so many details and mislead the Honorable Courts. It will be clear then. Then it will be very easy for us to deal the matter.
Along with our petition to court, what kind of documents we have to submit to the court for consideration of our petition?
First of all, with regard to our land or any property, we should be able to explain to the Honorable Courts that such and such a property belongs to me. Such and such a document is there. With that document, with the help of that document, I have purchased this kind of land. So, that document which explains this land belongs to me should be, for example, it may be coming from a revenue office. That document should be presented before the Honorable Court as our evidence.
Sir, you have just told me that revenue documents should be attached to the legal petition. What are those documents? Is it passbook and other any recorded evidence from the Department of Revenue we have to submit?
For example, every district of our country has a registration office. For example, when we purchase any land, we register that land with that registration office. First of all, that document we should obtain from the registration office. After that, we should present a copy of that registration office. It is enough for us. It's enough. That means such and such a land, so and so land belongs to me. This is the evidence. Your registration office itself has registered it. So that land belongs to me. This fact we should present before the Honorable Court as first instance.